Joining us by phone now, WGN legal analyst Terry Sullivan. Terry, good morning to you.
Good morning, Sean.
So tell me about this, Terry, because you covered the first trial from gavel to gavel, and we did not see this tape come up during that trial. Tell me about what's different now and why we didn't see this evidence come out 11 years ago.
Well, there's a lot that's the same, Sean, and then there's a lot that's different. And real briefly, I think what you're looking at is, what is this tape that they're claiming that they have? Is there more? Are there more than one tape that we're going to be looking at? And is R. Kelly on the tape? That was one of the main issues at the first trial some 10 years ago. And then one of the questions that's going to be is, where were these four women during that time? Because all of these allegations now are from before the trial back 10 years ago.
Terry, one of the issues in the trial last time was that the actual victim herself, alleged victim, I should say, herself, did not take the stand. Will it be different this time because Michael Avenatti, the lawyer who has this tape and who has given it to prosecutors and says he actually has more tapes, says that he represents one of the women in these tapes? Will it make a difference if you actually hear from one of the alleged victims this time when the case goes to trial?
Sure it will, Tanya. And one of the things we're going to have to look for in the far future is how many of these women will testify in the same trial. If each trial is separated and it's one-on-one, it's going to be more difficult for the prosecution. The more that they can get in at one trial, the better chance they have a conviction. Look at the Bill Cosby case. It was the same thing there, where they were able to bring other supposed victims forward, and they got the conviction. But I think one of the biggest things you're going to have is, not only was that R. Kelly on the tape, whatever tapes there are, again, we don't know how many there may be, is that him there, and where in the heck have the tapes been for the past 20 years. You have a real situation, and in this day of technology, you're going to have the defense, I'm sure, is going to have analysis and probably expert witnesses that are going to say that those tapes have been tampered with. So where have the women been? Where have the tapes been? And have they been tampered at all with?
The other question, Terry, is last time when this case, when he went to trial, there was almost 6 years between the time that the charges were brought and then the actual trial started. There were issues where witnesses may have forgotten instances, couldn't recall details in clarity. Is there any push to try to make sure that this case moves along a lot faster?
I'm sure there will be, but there will be complicated motions here that I'm sure, when it finally gets to a trial judge, that he or she is going to have to decide. I think that before they're able to say that they have any sort of good evidence, they're going to have to substantiate that, because that's what's going to be brought up by the defense. And then when you finally get to trial, as I said before, as unfair as it may be at times, certainly the alleged victims are going to be challenged with, where have they been, and why, when there was a trial to begin with 10 years ago, why didn't they come forward?
So in this case, the victims themselves become on trial as well.
Exactly. But that's what's going to have to happen here. That's what the defense is going to do. And you can bet your house on that. But the fact is that somebody is going to try to leave allegations with a jury that these women were around. And now what they're looking for, since he's at the top of his career again, or was a short time ago, that they're after the money now.
Yeah.
And we'll have to see how that flies in this Me Too age.
All right, Terry. We'll leave it there. WGN legal analyst Terry Sullivan, thank you. WGN will
continue.
All right. Continue to follow the R. Kelly story throughout all of our newscasts. And you can follow developments at WGNTV.com and on our free WGN news app.